their personal details. But this time, they asked us to submit additional and requiring us to submit even our passports. And on the opening day of Parangatan, our IDs were not issued because they said that they're still even checking for background, for intelligence, and there were even calls from the Washington Embassy to our offices in the world, checking if we are really employees of the company in Manila. So that's why. If you recall, a few days ago, there was an event at the Philippine Red Cross where they lost a new ship and Amazing Grace, that's the name of the ship, which was bought from Alaska. And for the first time, journalists, especially from the foreign media, were asked to submit two valid government IDs. They asked us to submit again passports or SSS or driver's license just to credit us, which they do not require us in the past. So we feel that these are repressions. These are signals that the government is not taking the media lightly, especially those who are critical of what they're doing. In fact, our Presidential Communications Office Secretary, Martin Adanar, has endorsed the bloggers to work with Malacanang Press Corps. And the problem is, they only accept bloggers who are very friendly to them. So probably if you are a blogger hitting the president, you will not be invited to join their group. So what Adanar is saying, why they invited the bloggers, why they had the social media policy, is that the traditional media has become tainted, and some are being paid by vested interest. So I think what is happening in the Philippines is also happening elsewhere, especially now in the U.S. with the press secretary of Donald Trump. And even Donald Trump, who at one press conference called the CNN fake news. So these are different times. So that's society. Going to technology, technology is becoming too fast for us to, for reporters, for journalists, to cope with. We now have so many mobile apps. In fact, most of the news now are being consumed through the mobile, your mobile phones. So, and there are also some technology that are being introduced, like virtual reality, augmented reality, which we are seeing to be a threat to what we do maybe 20 or 30 years ago. So, millennials are kind of up to these kind of changes. In our office, we have somebody who is very fast in transcribing speeches using his mobile phone. So the trust level of the people in our traditional media is at its lowest level because of fake news, cross, and the people are now doing a lot of citizen journalism. Maybe in the future, you will see more journalism paired with advertising. You will see that even global companies like Thomson Reuters are sometimes doing stories that are sponsored. And in the Philippines, I know that Rappler is doing a lot of campaigns for companies or for NGOs. And this is one of their funding sources. So when marketing and advertising takes control of your editorial policies, the question next is the media still independent? So I leave it at that for you.